Tonight, stocks are falling, banks are failing, and the nation is on edge after the second largest bank failure in U.S. history. Two federal agencies are now looking into the Silicon Valley bank collapse.
We must get the full accounting of what happened and why those responsible can be held accountable.
Last week, the bank announced it lost $1.8 billion, which basically meant SVB didn't have the cash they needed to pay their customers back, starting a run on the bank.
I rushed over here and I withdrew all my money, except for $1.
I know it's called Silicon Valley Bank, but the startups literally are all across the country, and they've got to pay their bills this week.
SVB's failure could have rippling effects across the country. So an FGCU professor decided to seize the moment and teach students about this historical event as it unfolds.
In tonight's cover story, ABC7's Amanda Lojeski sat in on the class and gets us more on why this failure doesn't mean panic. It means pay attention.
In Professor Tom Smythe's finance class.
Right. How many categories of securities are there from an accounting perspective? Three.
The lecture has the same focus as the nation right now, banks.
First of all, don't panic, especially for retail clients, folks like you and I. Why do you think they may not have lent money in form of loans? That's right. Nobody needed any money. Odds are they don't have deposits that are over $250,000, so they don't have anything to worry about.
The Silicon Valley bank collapse is the second largest bank failure in U.S. history.
It's a bit of turmoil and volatility spread across lots of markets.
From the stock market to the bond market.
So what you're telling me is they bought coupon-paying bonds that were essentially zero-coupon bonds. There's going to be some uncertainty, but overall, the banking system is incredibly sound.
Smythe says what happened with SVB is something people like himself who pay attention to the industry hadn't really thought about.
I would be concerned, or I am concerned, that regulators just missed something here.
And that's exactly why his students are breaking down how and why a bank like SVB failed.
Because at least on the surface, it looks like it could have been prevented.
In his hybrid class, he's able to bring in real-time events.
Ironically, we're not in a current crisis environment, yet we've got the 16th largest bank in the country failing. When things like this happen, it's very easy to then make that emotional connection for the student to what we've talked about in the class. Think SVB knew about this 2 weeks ago? Yeah, they probably did. They start slow in a semester. They figure out this is a pretty good deal. They start at today. Excellent questions, deep questions.
So will this lead to like tighter restrictions on banking securities?
You think that in the future, because of this, regulators will look more closely at off-balance sheet activities for banks?
Professor Smythe's message to his students and the public is the same.
I think for most people, status quo, don't make any rash decisions, don't go out and sell bank stocks, even though they've fallen 25%.
Which is why we need to pay attention.
There are a number of things that are coming that are going to be difficult to manage as it is. First one's next week, the Federal Reserve, the FOMC meeting.
What he means is the failure by SVB means our inflation rates could hold or even reduce.
The problem is either way they go is going to create volatility in the market. That doesn't mean inflation is gone, right? It's just everybody's piled into these treasuries because they believe they're safe until this crisis is averted.
In Fort Myers, Amanda Lojeski, ABC 7.